how it's gonna play out. I'm gonna be class, right? And I'm gonna come over, I'm in my cool walk. And I said, Shad, I was gonna say, Shad, you know, I know we worked on a project, I know we have a good relationship, so can you come with me to the dance? And I had it in my head. Back when people used to watch BET, so I had a Chris Brown video, I was like, yo, I had my swag on, I was like, okay. And mind you, for my dark skin fellas, that was before dark skin was even in. So, I know my middle table like, they're like, they're looking at me like, I walked over. And this is the funniest thing ever to happen, right? The funniest thing ever to happen. When I walked over and I asked her to go to the dance, she said, unfortunately, Greg, I already got somebody else. And I said, who is that? And it turns out it was my boy. I think this conference and the reason why they have these speakers, the reason why they have this is because we have far too many people in society that are on the wall right now. Why do you think when you go to McDonald's, I'm not going to point out McDonald's, but you go to certain restaurants and people are not happy. People, you order your food, they say, okay, can I take your order? You get there, you say, I want a honey mustard. They act like they own the honey mustard. They ain't give you honey mustard. And, there's a lot of unhappy people in society. You cut somebody off accidentally and all of a sudden it's road rage, they behind you, they hunking their horns. Are you so unhappy? And because guess what? A lot of people have admitted to being stuck on the wall. So if anything, if you don't remember anything I say tonight, always remember my head. In any situation where you kind of feel like you're holding back, realize that, hey, you have the opportunity, you have the ability to get off the wall, but also that it's, like I said, it's your responsibility, because guess what? Somebody is counting on you. And I'm going to get to the point after I do this, because I know this is a medical conference. And how many seniors do I have in here? Okay. Man, I'm happy. Oh my God. How many seniors are there in here? Okay, I like it. So, I told y'all I have a podcast, right? And a couple weeks I had the opportunity to interview this guy. He was a phenomenal undergrad student, phenomenal. And he applied to some schools, and his top schools of choices, unfortunately, kind of like this picture. He got denied. So this is a guy that put everything he had into his high school career. He did everything that his parents told him to do. He was with the counselors. He studied for the GMAT. He had a great score in his top two schools. And mind you, he wanted to be a doctor. He didn't get into. So what happened? He ended up choosing North Carolina Central University. HBCU in Durham, North Carolina. That's what he chose. And some people, when they choose a school like that, it's like, it's not big on research. They don't produce a lot of doctors. It's, honestly, it's not MIT and Harvard in the medical space. So some people, they would limit their expectations on what they should expect from the program. Because unfortunately, I have a lot of friends that go to certain schools just because they didn't get into UNC or the UNCGs, and they get to this program, the expectation is lower, and now all of a sudden, they're living the life of lack, they're being average. But what he said, when he went to North Carolina Central, he was like, yo, I'm gonna make the most of this opportunity. Every research grant he applied for, every summer opportunity he was in the biology person's office, and he was like, yo, how can I get better? What can I do? And all of a sudden now, when I interviewed him, not only does he have his PhD at MIT, but he's also in Harvard Medical School. Mind you, this is from North Carolina Central University. I mean, some of y'all in here probably have never heard of that school. And he utilized the opportunities within this, whatever opportunity he had, and now, not only a PhD, but he's in his second year at Harvard Med. So I'm telling you, once again, there's certain people in here that when y'all did all you can, and you're gonna get, some people might get rejected from the school of choice. But I challenge you to not have the mindset of, man, dang, I didn't get it, I'm not gonna accomplish anything, or maybe my goals need to be set a little shorter. If anything, that should align you to A. Whatever, if you think you're that dope, if you get to a smaller school, you should die.